Hello students, a very good morning to all. Welcome to the TSN online classes. Today I am going to explain class 11th chemistry chapter number 9, and the name of this chapter is hydrogen. Today topic is dihydrogen as a fuel. Dihydrogen release a large quantities of heat on a combustion. The dihydrogen can release more energy than petrol's hydrogen economy. The basic principle of the hydrogen economy is the transportation and storage of the energy in the form of liquid or gaseous dihydrogen. Energy is transmitted in the form of the dihydrogen and not as electric power. It is also used in fuel cell to generation of electric power. Now the next topic is hydrides. Dihydrogen also forms ionic bonds with some metals at a high temperature, creating a compound called a hydride. If E is a symbol of an element, then hydride can be expressed as EHX. The hydrides are classified into three categories: ionic or saline, and covalent and the molecular, the metallic and the non-stoichiometric hydrides. Now, periodic table of the elemental hydride types. The nearly all elements are able to form hydride compounds here. Here the pink color represent the covalent hydrides, the light blue color is the metallic hydrides, and the orange color is represent the intermediate hydride, and the yellow color is represent the ionic hydrides, and the white color is represent the hydrides gap. Now, ionic or saline hydrides, these are stoichiometric compounds of the dihydrogen formed with most the S block elements, which are the highly electropositive in character. Covalent character is found in the lighter metal hydrides. The ionic hydrides are crystalline, non-volatile and the non-conducting in solid state. Their metals conduct the electricity, and on the electrolysis liberate dihydrogen gas at anode, which confirms the existence of the H minus ion. So the saline hydrides react volatile with water, producing the dihydrogen gas. Now, covalent or a molecular hydride, the dihydrogen forms a molecular compound with most of the p block elements. ठीक है, तो आप बेटा इसका ध्यान रखना कि s block elements जो है वो metallic hydrides को represent करते हैं, and the p block elements जो है वो molecular compounds जो है वो बनाते हैं, यानी कि covalent hydrides बनाते हैं. For the example, CH4, NH3 and the H2O and HF. Hydrogen compounds of a non-metal have also been considered as hydrides. Being covalent, they are volatile compounds. Molecular hydrides are the further classified according to the relative number of the electrons and the bonds in their the Lewis structure into a electron deficient electron. Electron precise and the electron rich hydrides. Now here we are showing the electron deficient hydride and the electron precise hydrides and the electron rich hydrides. Now the metallic hydrides, these are formed by mainly D block and the F block elements. So यहाँ पे बेटा ध्यान रखना कि जो D block और F block के elements है, ये metallic hydrides बनाते हैं, and the metals of group 7, 8 and 9 do not form hydride. It's a very important line कि जो group 7, 8 और 9 है, ये किसी भी तरह के hydrides नहीं बनाते हैं. These hydrides conduct heat and the electricity through not as efficiency as their parent metal do. Unlike saline hydrides, they are the almost non-stoichiometric, being a deficient in a hydrogen. For example, LaH2 87 and the YbH2.55. Law of the constant compounds composition does not hold good. The property of the absorption of the hydrogen and the titration metal as a widely used in a catalyst, and the reduction, hydrogenation and the reaction for the preparation of the large number of the compound. Some of their metal are accommodate a very large volume of the hydrogen and can be used as a storage media. Now the very important topic next is water. So water, a major part of the living organism, is made up इज मेड अप ऑफ वाटर. वी नो वेरी वेल कि लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म का जो मेजर पार्ट होता है वो सब वाटर से ही है. एंड द ह्यूमन बॉडी हैज़ अबाउट 65% एंड द सम प्लांट्स हैव अ मच एज अ 90% ऑफ वाटर. तो ह्यूमन बॉडी में तकरीबन जो है 65% वाटर है. एंड जो कुछ प्लांट ऐसे होते हैं जिनमें 95% तक वाटर होता है. इट इज़ अ क्रूशियल कंपाउंड फॉर द सर्वाइवल ऑफ ऑल लाइफ फॉर्म्स. इट इज़ सॉल्वेंट टू अ ग्रेट इंपॉर्टेंस. Now the next is the physical property of the water. It is a colorless and the tasteless liquid. इसमें कोई भी color नहीं होता, कोई taste नहीं होता. The unusual properties of the water is the condensed phase. Liquid and the solid are due to the presence of the extensive hydrogen bonding between the water molecule. Water has a higher specific heat, thermal conductivity, surface tension and the dipole moment and the electric constant when compared to other liquids. It in and the extent solvent and the transportation of the ion and the molecules required for plant and the animal metabolism. Now the next is due to the hydrogen bonding with the polar molecules, even the covalent compound like alcohol and the carbohydrate dissolve in water. Now structure of the water here in the gas phase, water is a bent molecule with a bond angle of the 104.5 degree and OH bond length of 95.7 pm. It is a highly polar molecule and it is a liquid phase. Water molecules are the associated together by the hydrogen bonds. Now density of the water is more than of ice. यदि हम density की बात करें तो वाटर जो है उसकी डेंसिटी ज़्यादा होती है आइस की तुलना में. एंड द हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग इन वाटर आर हियर. द हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड्स आर द केमिकल बॉन्ड्स दैट फॉर्म बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स कंटेनिंग अ हाइड्रोजन एटम बॉन्डेड ऑफ द स्ट्रॉन्गली इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एटम. बिकॉज ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एटम पुल्स द इलेक्ट्रॉन फॉर्म द हाइड्रोजन एटम्स एंड द एटम्स फॉर्म अ वेरी पोलर मॉलिक्यूल्स. मीन वन एंड इज द नेगेटिव चार्ज एंड द अदर एंड इज अ पॉजिटिव चार्ज. हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड फॉर्म बिटवीन दीज मॉलिक्यूल्स because of the negative ends and the molecules are the attracted to the positive ends and the other molecules are vice versa. And the hydrogen bonding makes water from a liquid at a room temperature. Now the structure of the ice here, ice has a highly ordered three dimensional hydrogen bonded structure and the examination of the ice crystal with x-ray shows that the each oxygen atom is surrounded tetrahedral by the four other oxygen atom as a distance is a 276 pm. Hydrogen bonding gives ice a rather open type structure with wide holes and these holes can be hold some other molecules of the appropriate size. And the next is structure of the ice here. Now the chemical properties of the water, the amphotic nature. The first is the amphotic nature. It has the ability to act as an acid as well as a base. तो ये दोनों ही तरह के act कर सकता है. And it behaves as an amphotic substance in the Bronsted sense of the acts an acid with NH3 and the base with H2S. H2 when combined with the NH3, then the product is OH minus ion and NH4 plus ion and it is a reversible reaction. Now the second is H2 when combined with the H2S, the product is H3O plus ion and HS minus ion. The auto proteolysis of water take place as follow. H2O when combined with the H2O. Here H2O is an acid and the second H2O is base. Then the product is H3O minus and OH minus. Now redox reaction involving water. Water can be easily reduced to dihydrogen by highly electropositive metals. 2H2O when combined with the 2 sodium and the product is the 2NOH and H2. Thus it is a great source of the dihydrogen. इसीलिए ये dihydrogen का great source है. Water is oxidized to O2 during the photosynthesis. The 6 mole of carbon dioxide when combined with the 12 mole of the H2O, the product is the C6H12O6, 6 mole of water and the 6 moles of oxygen. With fluorine also is the oxidized to O2, then 2F2 when combined with the 2H2O, the result is 4H plus ion plus 4F minus ion and O2. Hydrolysis reaction due to the high dielectric constant. It is a very strong hydrating tendency. It dissolves many ionic compounds, have a certain covalent, and the some ionic compounds are the hydrolyzed in water. P4O10 when combined with the 6 mole of water, the product is 4H3PO4 and silicon trichloride. When combined with the 2H2O, the result is SiO2 plus 4HCl, and the N3 minus ion when combined with the 3H2O, the product is NH3 and 2 and 3OH minus ion. A hydrolysis process generally involves water. तो हाइड्रोलाइसिस का जो प्रोसेस होता है वो जनरली उसमें वाटर इन्वॉल्व ही होता है. हाइड्राइड्स फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम एक्वस सॉल्यूशन. मेनी सॉल्ट्स कैन बी क्रिस्टलाइज एज अ हाइड्राइड सॉल्ट्स सच एज अ एसोसिएशन ऑफ द वाटर इज ऑफ द डिफरेंट टाइप्स. फर्स्ट कोऑर्डिनेटेड वाटर इज CrH2O होल ट्वाइस 6 एंड इज अ होल ट्वाइस 3 प्लस 3Cl माइनस एंड द इंडस्ट्रियल वाटर एंड द हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डेड वाटर. तो उन सब के जो एग्जाम्पल हैं वो हमने आपको यहाँ पे बताए हैं. Now, what is heavy water? Heavy water क्या होता है? Heavy water, it is extensively used as a moderator in a nuclear reactor and in an exchange in a reaction for the study of the reaction mechanism. It can be prepared by the existing electrolysis of the water or as a byproduct in some fertilizer industries. Physical properties क्या होती हैं बेटे heavy water की? The formula is D2O and the physical property is the molecular mass is 20.0276 gram per mole. Melting point is 276.8 Kelvin and the boiling point is 374.4 Kelvin. Now the bottom ice cubes were made with the heavy water, which is water that uses deuterium hydrogen, not regular hydrogen, which has no neutron. Now what is the uses of it? It is used in a preparation of the other deuterium compounds. For the example, when CaC2 combined with the 2D2O, the product is C2D2 plus CaOD whole twice 2. The SO3 when combined with the D2O, the result is D2SO4, and the Al4C3 when combined with the 12D2O, the product is 3CD4 and 4AlOD whole twice 3. Now what is the summary of it? Hydrogen is the most abundant and the simplest element in the universe is a whole summary of this chapter. Hydrogen has no elasticity. Hydrogen is flammable and hydrogen is energy carrier. Hydrogen can be cooled and stored as a liquid. Atomic hydrogen is heavy reactive, highly reactive, and the nascent hydrogen is a very reactive form of hydrogen. Liquid and the compressed hydrogen storage technically feasible in use as a prototype vehicles and focus is on meeting packaging mass and the cost targets. Both methods fall below energy density goals and the unique vehicles and the unique vehicles architecture and the design architecture and the design could enable efficient packaging and the extended range. So solid state storage is a fundamental discovery and the intense development necessary. Idea rich research environment. So today your topic is completed. This chapter is completed today. And if you have any queries, then you will be asked me. And the question MCQs related to this chapter, I will be send you in the group. So आप वहाँ से इसे नोट डाउन कर लें और आपकी कोई भी क्वेरीज हो तो आप पूछ सकते हैं इससे रिलेटेड. एंड इट इज़ अ वेरी एंड द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर. सो आप बेटे अच्छे से इसे गो थ्रू कर लें. द आइसोटॉप्स ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट. द हैवी वाटर एंड द डाइनाइट्रोजन. ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच स्टूडेंट्स.